This morning we will study, you know, the Word of God. But before that, I would like you to bow down your heads as we pray. Father in heaven, we would like to thank you for the weekend's activities. We would like to thank you, Lord, for the time that we have spent together. We would like to thank you for the reminders that you have given to all of us, and we are blessed. We are happy for the services that you have given to us through the Delacruces, through our speakers, different speakers, Lord. And we would like to tell you, Lord, that we are now blessed and we are ready now to go back home to our respective places, willing to work for you. Thank you, Lord, for giving us this opportunity in which we could restore strength to our spiritual being. Thank you for many answered prayer and for giving us your words this morning. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. You know, yesterday I was listening to the Delacruces, you know, Dr. Jing Delacruz and Dr. Witz Delacruz. And they were telling us that in order to be successful in our work, especially in our plan to erect a sanitarium, is to forget self. Forget self, avoid pride, you know, self-sufficiency, and others. So I have been praying since yesterday, Lord, what shall I impart to our brethren who have come here to inspire them? But you know, negative. Even God used the negative things to approach, you know, some people. Like for example, Paul, you know, Saul of Tarsus. You know, the Lord did not talk to him like, you know, Elijah. No. He was hit by the lightning. And Saul, you know, asked, "Who are you?" And God, you know, told him about the work that he will be doing. But this morning we will study about one of the disciples, the negative disciples, Judas Iscariot. You know, the School of Theology conducted a week of prayer in Mountain View College, and I was absent. Now, I know, I was late because, you know, I work in the laboratory in agriculture. I have to wash my hands. I have to cleanse, you know, myself. I have to go to the bathroom. So I was a little bit late, and we decided to use the disciples. And when I arrived, you know, the only disciple that was not taken was Judas. And I said, "Oh, I don't like Judas." But Dr. Baliramo said, "You have to, I have assigned you already, you're late, so you take Judas." And I studied the life of Judas, you know, this morning. So this morning we will study the life of Judas. The reasons why Judas was not successful in following Jesus. Judas Iscariot is a disciple of Judas, of Jesus. The surname is Iscariot. And says he betrayed his master and then hung himself. A disciples had greatly desired that Judas should become one of their number. Why? Why do you think they wanted Judas to be one of their numbers? Because he was so talented. They had counted his accession an event of much promise to the apostolic band. What's the difference between disciple and apostles? So they said, when you are a disciple, you are a student. When you are an apostle, you are already a messenger, graduated already. You have graduated. So he did not become an apostle, a disciple, but you know, he failed to become an apostle. Judas had come more into contact with the world than the disciples. Oh, he knows all the people in the world. He knows the governors. He knows the president, you know. Judas was a man of good address. He could speak, you know, and people would listen. He is a good speaker. And Judas was a man of discernment. Oh, he could discern what is right and wrong. So disciples were really telling Jesus Christ, please take Judas. And Judas had an executive ability and financial ability. So in other words, he could be a good manager. In fact, he was chosen as the treasurer of the disciples. He was the one, you know, bringing the money. He has the executive ability. He could be the president of all the disciples. And Judas' desire to introduce into Christ's work were based upon worldly principles and were controlled by worldly policy, honor to the obtaining of the kingdom of this world. All things that he wanted to do is all, you know, worldly style. Judas was the only disciple that was not cold. All disciples were cold, Peter, James, and John. But Judas was not cold. He volunteered himself, you know, he volunteered himself. Very nice, huh? Volunteer himself. The only disciples, Judas was the only disciples from Judea. The 11 disciples were from Galilee, from Judea. You know, if you look at Galilee and Judea, that's east and west, western part of Israel is Galilee, and Judea is very far. You have to hike 2 days to 3 days to reach the place. And in Luke 9:57, he said, you know, he said to Jesus Christ, he said, I will follow you no matter where you go. And Jesus said, no, I don't have place to go. You know, Jesus replied, foxes have holes, and the birds of the air have nests, but the Son of Man have no place to lay his head. He thought, you know, when following Jesus, he could be, you know, somebody. He could be somebody. But no. The reasons why Judas did not succeed in following Jesus. I have only chosen 7. Because 7 is a complete number. You know, 7 churches, 7 trumpets, 7 last plagues, 7 Seventh-day Adventists. Reasons why Judas did not succeed in following Jesus. First reason, Judas did not humble his heart or confess his sins. You know, if you want to be successful even in building the sanitarium that we are planning, we should humble ourselves. That's why, you know, Dr. De La Cruz is always pointing heaven. Heaven always. Praise the Lord. It's always like that. Forget self. Then he did not also confess his sins. Man by nature is proud. You can read that in Gospel Workers, page 414. Meekness and lowliness of heart was given to the disciples an opportunity to learn in the school of Christ. 1 John 1:9, at the reproof of Jesus, his very spirit turned to gall. Wounded pride and desire for revenge. Every time that Jesus would rebuke him, he wanted to revenge. Pantay lang ka. You know, wanted to revenge. Gusto siya mabalos. That's Judas. That's the reason why he was not successful in following Jesus. Did not humble his heart, nor confess his sins, nor... Second reason, Judas was the one who introduced an element of antagonisms among the disciples. Education, page 91. Expressed doubts that confused the disciples. He introduced controversies and misleading sentiments, statements, repeating the arguments urged by the scribes and the Pharisees against the claim of Christ. So he was the one, he repeated that doubts, you know. So it was Judas who introduced this. And he would introduce texts from the scripture that had no connection with the truths. You know, did not, sometimes, you know, it's out of context, huh? It is Judas was the one who did that. The dissensions to which of them should be the greatest was generally excited by Judas. Kinsay sikat? Who is the greatest? It was Judas who started that. Third, he loved the praise of the world. He refused to give up the world for Christ. He held up high standard for others, but he himself utterly failed to reach the Bible standard. He wanted to be praised by the world. Oh, you're the greatest. You're the greatest. You know, you're the greatest. I love that, you know. I like to be praised. Oh, I tell you, when I was, you know, in college, I don't have money to pay my tuition every fiesta of Malay Balay and Valencia, I would go and join, you know, boxing. And I am happy, you know, to hear people, they would stand and shout, you know, tutu, tutu, tutu. And, you know, I really love it. I like it. But, you know, when I read the life of Judas, I said, oh, loving the praise of the world. He refused to give up the world for Christ. That's not good, eh? The fourth reason why Judas was not successful in following Jesus, you know, he wanted to be popular, okay? Love of popularity and self-love and praise exclude Jesus from the heart. So if you want to be popular, if you want to be, you want to love yourself always, you want to be praised, you know, then Jesus will not live in your heart. Christ Object Lesson, page 162. It is the absence of Christ that makes the countenance sad and the life of pilgrimage subsides. Daghang mga panghayhay if Jesus is not in our hearts. Those who are filled with self-esteem and self-love do not feel the need of a living, personal union with Christ. The heart that has not fallen on the rock is proud of his wholeness. Men want a dignified religion. They desire to walk in a path wide enough to take their own attributes. What are our attributes? It's opposite from the attributes of God. Their loves, their self-love, their love of popularity, the love of praise exclude the Savior from the hearts. You know, in Proverbs 16 and 19, we are told, you know, these seven things that really God does not like. That's why Jesus, in his Sermon on the Mount, he said, blessed are the poor in spirit. Poor in spirit. Blessed are the poor in spirit. Forgetting self. Okay? Forgetting self. Number four, Judas did not listen to his conscience or yield or surrender to Jesus. You know, the word surrender is the word that especially the soldiers does not like. Surrender. Huh? Surrender? Huh? But when we surrender to Jesus, we win. We win. You know, in the fight against the world, we have to surrender to Jesus, not to surrender to our enemy. He continued to cherish his own judgment and opinions, his disposition to criticize and condemn. Many of their contentions for supremacy, much of their dissatisfaction with Christ's methods originated with Judas. Judas violated his conscience and yielded to temptation, fastening upon himself more securely his habits of evil. So these habits, you know, he likes, you know, to do always. Habits become what? Becomes character. Okay? So you do that always, you do that always, it will become your character. You know? Repeated action will become a habit, and a habit will become a character. So thoughts, and you will reap acts. So acts, and you will reap habits. So habit, and you will reap character. And so character, and you will reap your destiny. Number five, reason why Judas was not successful in following Jesus. He thought himself wiser than Christ. Oh, I tell you, Judas. He thought himself wiser than Christ. You know, why did God do this? When we question that, we are thinking that we are wiser than the Lord. You know, an engineer, two of them, one engineer who was a very pious boy when he was a small boy, became an atheist. He said, no, I do not believe in God anymore. Why? Look at the mango. You know, it has a big trunk, but look at the fruits. Smaller fruits hang around. But he said, look at this squash. Yeah, squash, small. Small vines, but look at the fruits. I cannot understand. Mango, bigger trunk. But according to the story, the wind blew and the engineer was hit by one of the fruit. And his fellow engineer friend who believes in God said, see, if God made the fruit of the mango bigger, like the fruit of the squash, he will be dead now. But Judas, you know, feel like that too. He thought wiser than Christ. You know, many times he wanted to teach God. You know, God, why? Why did you do this? This is supposed to be Lord. We teach God, you know. Judas was like that. Okay? Six, Judas was a religious fraud. Pakitang tao, we say plastic. He say this and he do not follow it. You know, plastic, he was a religious fraud. The last, Judas loved the money. You can read that in Matthew 26:15 and also manuscript 28:1897. He sold his master with 30 pieces of silver. How much? 30 pieces of silver. That's the price of a slave during the time of Jesus Christ. Imagine that. When you love money, they said money is not evil. But the love of money is the root of all evil. These are Ages 371. Our money has not been given us that we might honor and glorify ourselves. As faithful stewards, we are to use it for the honor and the glory of God. Some think that the only portion of their means is the Lord's. When they have set apart a portion for religious and charitable purposes, they regard the remainder as their own. You know, I have given tithes already, given, you know, second tithe, so this is mine. The 80% is my own money. But you think, you listen. Something, you said, when they have set apart a portion for religious and charitable purposes, they regard the remainder as their own, to be used as they see fit. But in this, the mistake. All we possess is the Lord's, and we are accountable to Him for the use we make of it. In the use of every penny, it will be seen whether we love God supremely and our neighbor as ourselves. See? Christ Object Lesson 352. So even the money that remains in our pocket is not ours. You know, money has great value because it can do great good. In the hands of God's children, it is food for the hungry, drink for the thirsty, and clothing for the naked. It is a defense for the oppressed and a means of help for the sick. But money is of no value than sand, only as it is put to use in providing for the necessities of life, in blessing others, and advancing for what? Advancing the cause of Christ. Christ Object Lesson 351, 353. I would like you to read this. All of us should read this. Christ objection 353, shall we say together? Hoarded wealth is not merely useless. It is a curse. In this life, it is a snare to the soul, drawing the affections away from the heavenly treasure. In the great day of God, it's witness to unused talents and neglected opportunities will condemn its possessor. You know, brothers and sisters, money is talent. Money is talent. We need money to build sanitarium. It is talent. It is a gift from the Lord. But you know, when you have money, you have hoarded money, it will be useless, according to me. Reasons why Judas did not succeed in following Jesus. First, Judas did not humble himself, did not humble his heart or confess his sins. Second, Judas was the one who introduced an element of antagonism among the disciples. He loved the praise of the world. He refused to give up the world for Christ. And Judas did not listen to his conscience or yield or surrender to Jesus. He thought himself wiser than Christ. And sixth, Judas was a religious fraud, and he loved money more than God. He loved money more than God. Now, I would like to ask you to stand as we pray this morning. Shall we pray? Can we kneel down if those of you are able to kneel down? Father in heaven, today we will go home to our respective places. We pray, Father, for the double portion of your love. We praise you. We acknowledge you, Lord. We magnify you because you are so good to us. You brought us here. We would like to thank you for the blessings that you have given to all of us, especially to the De La Cruzes, to our different speakers, Ron Ron, Pama's Ministries, Sir Boys, Lalang, De Villa Vicentius, all the rest of the ministers that are here, O Lord. We would like to thank you, Father, for giving us this opportunity to be here, to listen to you through our speakers and through our companions that are here. O Father, we felt that we are not worthy to work for you. But we are happy, Lord, that even though we are sinners, you are still willing to accept us and to use us in your work. You have seen our hearts, O Father. We are sinners and we cannot cleanse ourselves. We have nothing, Lord, nothing to be proud of. But we are proud of your Son, Jesus Christ, who are willing to use us. Many times you wink your eyes on our sins. We are weak, but we are happy, Lord, that you are strong. And so unite our weaknesses to your strength, O Father, and our ignorance to your wisdom. I pray in special way that a double portion of your Holy Spirit be poured to us this morning. But before that, cleanse us all, Father, from all our sins, from our sins. Many times, O Lord, we do not know that we sin against you through our words, to our thoughts, to our deeds. So please cleanse us, Father, so that we will be worthy of receiving your Holy Spirit. Thank you so much for possessing us and for blessing us and for guiding us and for the assurance that you will save us when you come, together with our loved ones, with our children, together with our relatives and friends. Oh Father, thank you for your assurance. And I pray that from this time on, you help us and guide us and give us the strength to continue to work for you. Thank you for many answered prayer and for blessing all of us. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Let's sing Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit of God, dwell in me and let my life cast away every sin in my soul. Will you take full control of my life and make me whole? Holy Spirit of God, dwell in me.